Yes, yes, Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana. If you look at today's Standard newspaper, they have captured a very, very interesting story. Why Kalonzo won't be Raila running mate? And then down there, push to have ODM leader pick a deputy from vote-rich Mount Kenya, leaving the Wiper leader without a major role, is causing jitters among Kalonzo's allies and is a stumbling block to Kenyatta-led negotiation. And if you go through that story, it's just telling us that behind the scenes, Kalonzo and Raila are talking. They are in negotiations. But what is making it very, very hard for them to come to a deal is because Raila's team seems to be keen on picking a running mate from Mount Kenya and not Kalonzo Musyoka. That's what is causing some friction. Yes. And largely from where I sit, I tend to believe that's happening because if you look at Kalonzo Musyoka, Kalonzo in the recent days, or rather sometimes, he has been appearing to be undecided. So I tend to feel Raila, since time is running out, and these people are still undecided whether to work with him or whether to go it alone. So that's leaving Raila with no option but to look for a running mate from Mount Kenya. But having said that again, I still strongly believe as of today that Kalonzo still comes out as the best running mate that can deputize Raila Amolo Odinga. And I'm saying that largely because of five reasons which we are going to look into details. So if in case you've just bumped on this YouTube channel for the very, very first time, kindly subscribe, give this video a like. And before we look at these five reasons, let me say this. It does not matter whether Kalonzo is Raila's running mate or not for the Kambas to vote for Raila. As long as Kalonzo supports Raila, whether it's Raila's running mate, Kambas will still likely vote for Raila because they consider Kalonzo their ethnic kingpin. And now that Kalonzo has supported or endorsed Raila, Kambas might still decide to support Raila even without Kalonzo being Raila's running mate. Let that be very clear. And then secondly, Raila need not again to appoint a running mate from Mount Kenya for him to get votes from the mountain. Because again, as long as the mountain views Uhuru Kenyatta as their kingpin and Uhuru endorses Raila, then still a good portion of Mount Kenya residents will still vote for Raila just because of that endorsement from Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. It's all about what the ethnic kingpins are saying. The first reason, ladies and gentlemen, back to our analysis, the first reason why I believe Kalonzo is still the best to deputize Raila Odinga is that if Kalonzo deputizes Raila, then largely NASA 2017 strongholds are locked. Largely NASA's strongholds in 2017 are locked. And in 2017, it's widely believed that NASA won that election. So if NASA can still hold together, then even this election, they just need some bit, just a bit of the mountain vote to win it with a landslide. That's a given fact. So I believe that in 2017, if you look at the way NASA voted, in NASA, the NASA vote, Raila brought about 75% of that NASA vote in 2017. Kalonzo brought about 15%. Musalia brought about 10 or 8%. So if you add Raila's vote and Kalonzo's vote, then about NASA vote in 2017, then about 90% of NASA vote in 2017 is intact. So Raila just needs a bit of the mountain vote to win the presidency. That's the first reason. Secondly, in Oka team, it's only Kalonzo Musyoka who comes out as a strong candidate who controls his backyard. You will also agree with me that about, let's say, over 70% of Kambas subscribe to Kalonzo's brand of politics. Or rather, about 70% of the Kamba vote, that one Kalonzo has locked. So look at Musalia Mudavadi. That's not the case in Western, and it's not the case with Gideon Moi and also Moses Masika Wetangula. So in this team of Oka, the only strong person or personality that you can work with and you can be guaranteed of some votes is only Kalonzo Musyoka. So I believe that with that again, then Kalonzo comes out as the best candidate to deputize Raila Amolo Odinga.
Yes.
And then thirdly, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to help Raila again to debunk two community domination mantra. Because since independence, Kenya has been ruled by only two communities. And that's a discussion that President Uhuru Kenyatta started some time back when he told Kenyans that maybe it's now time to think about other communities. Look at William Ruto. William Ruto seems to be keen on picking a running mate from Mount Kenya. So technically, William Ruto will be a challenging Kikuyu affair. And that's what Kenyans are trying to run away from. So if Raila picks Kalonzo or any other candidate who is not a Kalenjin or a Kikuyu, then he will be in a better position to actually attack and demonstrate to Kenyans that it's time for change. But if he picks a running mate from Mount Kenya, then that his message can be watered down a little bit. And then fourthly, ladies and gentlemen, for the many years Kalonzo has served in government, his name has featured less in corruption activities or in corrupt deals or activities. So he can help Raila here again effectively demonstrate his seriousness in the fight against corruption, assuming they form the government. Look at William Ruto. William Ruto has been mentioned in so many numerous scandals. And the person William Ruto is most also likely to appoint as his running mate is also somebody who has also been charged of corruption. So with Kalonzo as Raila's running mate, then they will effectively demonstrate to Kenyans that they are a crop of leaders who are clean, and the other side is full of corrupt personalities and individuals. So Kalonzo deputizing Raila, because for the time he has been in government, he has been featured less in corruption, he can just help Raila demonstrate that they are serious about fighting corruption and that their team is a very clean team compared to William Ruto's team. And then finally, ladies and gentlemen, for the time Kalonzo has served as Raila's deputy, both in CORD 2013 and NASA 2017, he has proved that that he can work together with Raila Amolo Odinga. There have been no serious disagreements between these two leaders. Imagine they have held together and they were not in government. They had no power. They were in the opposition, but they still managed to hold together. And we never saw some disagreements during all this time between Raila and Kalonzo. An indication that Raila and Kalonzo can actually work very peacefully and can just make sure that they deliver on the services or on the promises they will be making to Kenyans. Not this one we have today, the case like Uhuru and Ruto, where each is just trying to outdo the other. But Kalonzo has proved that he can be loyal. He can be loyal to his boss, something that Ruto has failed to prove. Otherwise, ladies and gentlemen, I know there might be other reasons why Kalonzo is still best placed to deputize Raila Odinga, but I've summarized them into five so that you can understand me easily and very, very fast. Otherwise, as I conclude, let me remind you also that if you've just bumped on this YouTube channel for the very, very first time, kindly subscribe, give this video a like. Give it a like, please. Give it a like. If you are watching us for the very, very first time, and you are outside Kenya, drop a comment. Let us know from which part of the globe you are watching us from. Drop a comment. And if you have not yet subscribed again, subscribe, give this video a like. To our fans and subscribers in this YouTube channel, I'm very, very much happy and very, very grateful for the kind of support you are giving me in this channel by constantly on a daily basis giving our videos likes and also by dropping your comments on a daily basis. God bless you. God bless Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana.